Good morning and welcome to day 2 of Border War 11. One of the, if not the biggest milsim in whole Central Europe, where freaking all the countries from all over Europe gather together to make a huge airsoft war here in Czech Republic. Now, today's plan is to team up again with Silo, Fabi and Sinan, and we're gonna head out towards the village to fulfill our LARP mission. We already got intel that the guerrillas are quite close to our base. Here we can see the entry of the base. So I think as soon as we head out like 200, 300 meters, we're gonna have the first contact already. So we have to sneak through them somehow to get towards the village.
Now we get it there.
Headquarters.
See, I told you, undercover recon sniper. No name.
Revolutionary headquarters. That is ours. I'm gonna see you dead afterwards.
She seems to be.
Die sagen wir nicht der Mama, geh.
Wir schossen von hinten.
Jawohl! Kill him!
That's what he kept for searching me, you little bastards.
I keep this. This is not yours.
Yeah, keep it. No, it's I have given it to me.
I don't care.
There is nothing on there.
But I think I'm gonna kill him with his own gun. This is more fun than that.
Dear Novrich fans, I'd like to present the execution of your favorite YouTuber. As you can see, we are currently preparing the greatest kill ever made on YouTube in Airsoft. And of course, look at the patch. If you see us, you better run. What are your last word?
You insurgents!
Just got shot, medicked, and then searched and executed. So those are like the role play parts of the milsim, which you don't have to accept them. Like if you're not into this, if it's too much, you can always say no. But it's a ton of fun, just adds to the whole experience, and funny stuff always happens.
It seems to be.
When they took me hostage and searched me, they actually took my ID card, and I need the ID card in order to pass those guards here. Wish me luck, otherwise I don't have a home anymore. Okay, how do I get a new one, do you know?
In you need HQ. To go to HQ Romeo to
ask for a new one.
Ask for a new one.
Okay, I'm gonna do it. Thanks for letting me pass. Yeah, I got once again tortured and executed.
Me too.
Oh, you too?
Yeah.
Great, good for you. Okay. Now we have 1 hour of respawn time. Man, we should just get some food. I'm so hungry. I think the bottle is leaking or something.
Yeah, everything is wet in there.
Who closed it like this?
You.
Me?
Yeah, I gave it to
what?
You.
You need some food. Are you guys hungry?
Yeah.
Fuck. Oh, yeah, let's get some food.
I got the monies.
Quick lunch break. We had plenty of combat, so I need some fatty sausage or something.
It seems to be.
Something with a lot of calories. And they have that stuff all there. Do you have goulash?
No.
No? Today's menu. What's a cabbage soup? Forest curry chicken, yes. Respawn time is 1 hour, so now I have some time to show you guys the actual camp and how it looks like. So we have all kinds of tents everywhere. We have all those country flags, since Border War is, you know, it's a gathering of whole Europe. All the people are coming here. We have people from France, we have people from Spain, we have people from the UK. Seriously, this is all over Europe. I've even met people from Panama who actually flew here for, you know, just to try this game. It's pretty crazy. So Central Europe in general is great for airsoft. There's always stuff going on, there's always big milsims, and there's plenty of fields everywhere. I just met Costco, and he is the squad leader that runs this vehicle over here. How did you guys build it?
It's a base of La Daniva.
Can we have a look at it really quick?
Yeah.
Dang! Yeah, that's super military grade here, huh? Is it allowed on the street? It's not allowed on the street, right?
It's okay to go on the street because all are removable.
So. Oh, there's an actual license shield here. You actually drove it here on the street?
Yeah, we can. We just have to remove this part.
Yeah? Okay, what is it? It's all wood, right?
It's all wood.
Whoa, what did you put on top of there? What's this gun?
15 caliber.
Yeah?
M2. It's all handmade.
Oh, it's it's wooden. And,
it's V12 Vulcan inside. Yeah?
Okay, so HP engine.
Yeah.
I thought it's a real one. I thought you guys took a real one and put it in there. This is just plywood put together.
Yeah.
And it's this metal color that makes it look so realistic. Yeah. Nice. And the barrel is?
The barrel is a PVC.
PVC pipe. Okay. Man, it looks great. Really.
But we can still play.
Okay. Yeah. Nice. So all of this is just assembled on site?
Yeah.
The whole... God damn it. That's a lot of work, huh? So this thing is actually street capable. Then the shield, of course. Very important. Yeah, man, great job. Thumbs up for this one. Here we have team camouflage. Completely camouflaged car. One. Second one over there. And even their tents. I don't know where you can get this amount of camo tarp. It's not even cheap anymore. But it looks lit. They have like their own camp. People are really well prepared when it comes to border war. Not me. I'm just here with a tent, but you know, some people just go the extra mile. They build those cars. They make huge camps just like this one. They bring their military tents. So great stuff. Logistic-wise, a milsim of this size is, I think it's horrible. Like, it's really hard to organize. They have like sanitary tents. They have food for everybody, of course. They need to provide water. They need to, you know, have toilets and stuff. They also have shops if people forgot stuff.
So bleh!
And the Russians. Yeah, so they got you covered. They brought it all here. And I think what's really difficult is that they set this whole thing up in an area where people are not supposed to be. Like, nothing is here. There's no running water. There's no electricity. So they have to bring all the stuff and just set up this city, basically. I mean, it's... I think this year it's 1,500 people, so they have to bring all the basic supplies for all those folks. But even if you just bring, you know, your gear, a tent, and a sleeping bag, that's really all you need. The rest is provided by them. That's been it for us with Border War 11. Any last words? Fabi, Silo?
I'm exhausted.
Silo looking dark with the helmet still. Just take it off, man.
Safety first.
Yeah, I think what we all learned is that helmets just really suck and then we don't like them. But that was a great experience. Huge field, but we did still have plenty of enemy contact. So we had our fun. Gonna go there next year again, probably. Not sure yet, but we should find some other milsims. Maybe Russia, maybe Burgett. We'll figure it out. See you guys on the next milsim. Just realized that I lost my mobile phone somewhere in this forest. On it! It's right there. Ooh, that's a lot of footage right there. Thanks a lot. So, how long are you playing Airsoft?
10 or 11 years.
10 or 11 years? What's your name?
Keks.
Keks. Okay, here's your shout out. What's your YouTube channel name?
Keks Unterwegs.
Huh? Keks Unterwegs. Okay, Keks Unterwegs. You guys can check out the YouTube channel. I'm gonna link it below there. Thanks for helping me fight the phone. People are always nice and friendly here. Even if they go into roleplay mode, they're respectful, so.
Seems to be.
Great community, once again.